Developer docs are the critical link between I don't know to I know. We're lucky to have a special guest from the Learn Documentation universe to show us how AI is making that easier for you. So I'm sure you've been in a learning doc repo or whatever, trying to figure something out, and you look at the code sample and you know this should be easier with AI. Well, we're in luck because the Cozy AI Kitchen welcomes Megha Anand. Welcome, Megha.
Hi. Hi, John.
As a content developer, right?
Yeah. Thank you for having me. I am a content developer on the Learn Documentation team, and I work primarily on Visual Studio Docs.
And AI has happened. I'm sure you've noticed because you've changed how we do documentation.
Yes. So we are in the AI moment, and we want to be part of it. So.
Well, show us what you have, Chef Anand.
Yeah. So as a technical writer on developer documentation, my primary goal is to create documentation for developers that's practical and useful, something that they can apply in their day-to-day. And one of my personal interests is to show how AI can be used to help with real coding tasks. And that's where the idea of Copilot highlights comes in. Bringing AI right into our Learn documentation, into our existing docs, to show how Copilot could help them with their day-to-day tasks.
And how do developers feel before they discover this resource?
I think our goal is to demystify Copilot for our users so that they can see practical applications of how they might use AI and how AI could help them in their day-to-day workflows.
And you've been handcrafting, hand-foraging all these prompts. So please, Chef Anand.
Yeah. I want to dive right in and show you an example of where we've added a Copilot highlight section to a doc. Copilot highlight is actually a section that we add to an existing doc where we show the user a scenario with a Copilot example of how they might apply it in the context of what the doc focuses on to simplify or speed up a task that the article focuses on.
It's like an AI highlighter or something.
Yeah, it shows them how to use AI for the task. So this is a document on migrating code from Newtonsoft.json to system.txt.json. The article itself focuses on laying out the differences between the two and how walking the user through how they might migrate their existing code. And with a Copilot highlight, this article lends itself well to a Copilot highlight scenario because it is one of those complex tasks where Copilot can add real value. And so we show the user how they can use AI assistance to migrate their existing code. We added a section, Use AI to Migrate, with a practical and a task-focused actionable prompt example. They can adapt the example to their project. They can copy or just be aware that there is something like this they can try in there.
I can tell you how many times I've gotten that error where I'm using Newtonsoft and says, this is so useful. And then So this is your own custom prompt with a one-shot example. So how do people use this?
Developers, they can just copy and paste and give it a try in Copilot in their dev environments, particularly with GitHub Copilot and Visual Studio VS Code, where it gets a context of your project as well. But these prompts are very contained in the sense that you could take this example and give it a try and see the results and see how Copilot might add value to your workflow.
You have more examples as well.
Yes, I do. And then another example. So we've been picking docs which are high traffic docs, which are getting started documentation for users. For example, this is a Python for beginners doc, and it the AI section added here is about how to enhance the game with additional features. The document itself walks the user through setting up their Python environment and started with creating their first Python game.
It's a recipe.
It is. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it's our goal is to show AI in action. So they can see how AI might help with their day-to-day tasks and the value add that Copilot can bring.
Oh, so good. And so like when users use this and they can get started, they can follow the recipe, they can use AI as their kind of coach or maybe their Copilot. It's great. What else do you have?
There's some other examples. This documentation is on creating and deploying function code to Azure using Visual Studio Code. This is another one of those like complex dev tasks where Copilot can simplify a task for you or speed up a task for you. It can really take away the difficult, complex portions and make it easier for you to help understand. So using AI to normalize and validate input, this is in the context of what this article is talking about. And so the prompt is tailored to a use case in the context of the article.
So when you think about a lot of these examples, you talked about context be really important for the Copilot. Can you talk about why the developer needs context, Copilot needs it as well?
Yeah, I think in the context of the documentation, context actually means that the examples that we're adding to a particular doc would be regarding what the article focuses on. It would be in the flow of, like, for example, if it's a doc that's talking about like migration, or if it's a doc that's talking about serialization of JSON, then the example, prompt example in there would be tailored to the what the documentation is talking about. So it would be a serialization prompt. Context engineering in the context of your IDE is actually like Copilot in Visual Studio or VS Code understands the context of your project. So the prompt that you would put in there, Copilot would try to tailor its response, keeping in mind the context of the project that's open in the IDE. So
makes sense. Context, they say context is king or context is queen.
Yeah.
Great. Let's keep going. Let's keep cooking.
Yeah, so we've been trying to go through some of our docs that we think add value to our users, that users are visiting often, and trying to add these sections in. Like this is another doc, which is about writing .NET objects as JSON on serialization. So here's a section on how to serialize to JSON, and this is a practical, actionable example prompt that users can just be aware of, like this is something that they can do with Copilot, or they can actually take this and give it a try themselves. Our goal is for developers to see what they can do with Copilot, the value it can add, right, but by trying it for themselves. It's not like about promotion or hype. It's about like, go, give it a try, see the value add that it can bring in your day-to-day workflows. So firsthand. Trial. Yeah.
I've been in these Learn Docs a lot, and I'm really excited to get my Copilot prompt thanks to you. Do you have any message out there for content developers who are wondering what they should do in their future?
This is a great career. Like, you get to be on the cutting edge of technology. Like, right now we are in the AI moment, and we're getting to try all the AI tools and getting to write about them and helping developers see firsthand how we can enable them to be empowered to take advantage of these tools. And so I do want to also encourage community participation. Like, these docs are for the users. And so if you're using them and if you come across scenarios where like you see something you've tried and it has worked for you, send it our way, or feel free to contribute yourselves to the document. Like, let's get lots of, AI scenarios in there for folks to try.
Okay, learning community, you heard Chef Anand. Thanks a lot for coming by. See you soon.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.